Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Cristina Corazza. I am the director of the Congress Bureau of the International Center for Medical Methods in Engineering, CIMNE. On behalf of the Congress organizers, it is my great pleasure to welcome you all to this great Congress, jointly promoted by IACM and ECCOMAS. I am also happy to introduce you the members of the head table, chaired by Professor André Mas Pinel, Minister for Economy and Knowledge of the Catalonian Government. The table includes the presidents of the IACM and ECCOMAS, Professors Yengi Yagawa and Ekehard Brown, the director of the Civil Engineering School of Barcelona, representing the Technical University of Catalonia, the UPC, Professor Sebastián Oliveria, and the three co-chairs of the Congress, Professors Eugenio Oñate, Javier Oliver, and Antonio Huerta. Without further delay, I pass the word to the chair of the 11th World Congress on Computational Mechanics, Professor Eugenio Oñate. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Cristina. Dr. Mas Pinel, president of the IACM and ECCOMAS, director of the School of Civil Engineering, dear colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to welcome you all to this 11th edition of the World Congress on Computational Mechanics, promoted by the IACM, held in conjunction with the 5th European Congress on Computational Mechanics and the 6th European Conference on Computational Fluid Dynamics, both promoted by ECCOMAS. This opening session is the happy ending of 4 years of hard work. Many colleagues in CIMNE, the Spanish Association for Medical Methods and Engineering, in the School of Civil Engineering in the Technical University of Catalonia, and in CIMNE, all of those who have contributed to overcoming the exceptional challenge of organizing simultaneously 3 major international scientific events. The outcome, in my opinion, has exceeded all expectations. And also I think that this indicates that the international community of computational methods is happy to join forces and participate in global scientific meetings like this one, that is characterized by its transdisciplinarity versus the mathematical models and the numerical methods presented, and its thematic broadness covering almost every field in computational engineering and applied sciences. The numbers shown in the slide indicate evidence that this meeting is already a landmark in its field. You can read that we have on top the opening and closing lectures, 6 plenary lectures, 30 semi-plenary lectures, and this is new, including 3 young investigators' lectures and an industrial lecture on aeronautics. Close to 3,200 presentations will be organized in 216 mini symposia, 8 special technological sessions in aeronautics, 26 contributed sessions, and what is also new, there will be 115 posters authored by delegates who have decided themselves to present their work in the form of a poster. And I think this is an interesting concept that probably will follow in future conferences. In the next transparency, that probably you cannot read, shows that the number of delegates will exceed 3,600. It was only yesterday we had some 100 delegates more, yesterday on the site. And there are 10 countries with over 100 delegates. I will read the first five countries. Germany is not only leading in soccer, also in this congress is the first Brazil and Spain will keep a low profile in United States, 390, France, also very close to France, so maybe these numbers will change in the last day of the conference. We'll update the figures because I can see a strong competition between the United States and France. Anyway, you can read the numbers in the transparency. And in the last slide in this series, I show in a statistical, not a statistical, a distributional presentation of the participants, and you can see that there is a smooth transition from the largest country to the smallest one. I have to admit, however, that we are a bit worried by the size of this event and the responsibility to run simultaneously 48 parallel sessions. Half of them will take place in this building and the other half in the adjacent hotel, which is only 200 meters away. For all these reasons, and on behalf of all the organizers and the team, I kindly ask you for your patience and indulgence for any mistakes and misadjustments that may occur during the Congress, which we hope it will be not too many. Finally, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to all who have participated one way or another in the organization of this joint Congress, to the international organizations, the speakers, the attendants, the exhibitors, and last but not least, to all of you who have contributed with your presence to the success of this event. I hope you all have a fruitful and enjoyable week in Barcelona from the scientific, professional, and social point of view. Thank you very much.
I ask now Professor Xavier Oliver, Chair of the 5th European Conference on Computational Mechanics and President of the Spanish Association for Medical Methods in Engineering, to say some words.
Ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues and friends, as Chairman of the European Conference on Computational Solid and Structural Mechanics, it's a pleasure to welcome you to this edition in 2014 in Barcelona. Also, I would like to welcome you very especially as President of the Spanish Association for Numerical Methods in Engineering, CIMNE. CIMNE is the host organization of this joint conference. It's a medium-sized but very active scientific association in Spain. It was founded in 1989, so that it turns 25 years in 2014. And we haven't found a better way to celebrate this anniversary while serving the computational mechanics community than jointly organizing three conferences. The World Congress on Computational Mechanics of the IACM, and the two European Conference on Computational Solid Mechanics and Computational Fluid Dynamics of the ECCOMAS. A large part of the world scientific community on computational mechanics is meeting in Barcelona during this week to present, discuss, and consolidate the last developments in our scientific fields. And as the host association of the event, CIMNE is very proud to have served for this purpose. Certainly, this is one of the largest scientific events that can be organized nowadays in our community, and CIMNE has taken the challenge. This huge organizational effort has been made possible with the enthusiastic support and collaboration of many people. The scientific community in CIMNE, the support and technical assistance of the International Center for Numerical Methods in Engineering in Barcelona, CIMNE, the Congress Secretariat, and most important, with the confidence of the thousands of delegates, you, who have decided to come to Barcelona to participate in the conference. The organizers will feel rewarded for our efforts if at the end of this week you think that this 2014 joint congress deserved your attendance. Enjoy the conference, enjoy your stay in Barcelona. Thank you very much.
I now ask Professor Antonio Huerta, Chair of the SIF European Conference on Fluid Dynamics, to close the welcoming addresses of the Congress of Chairs.
Dear authorities, colleagues and friends, now is my turn as a ECCOMAS CFD Chair to address you a few words, but don't panic. I always try to follow Mark Twain when he said, if you are a bad speaker, but you are brief, people will never find out. This is the sixth edition of ECCOMAS CFD conference, but it's the first time we are organizing it jointly with her sister conference, ECCM. And this is thanks to the effort of the President of ECCOMAS, Professor Ram, and the past President of ECCOMAS, Professor Papadrakakis, and their team. It's also the first time we are joining these two conferences with WCCM. Thank you, Professor Yagawa, for helping us doing that. There is always this big discussion on how big is big, how big should be a conference. I can tell you that it's difficult for the organizers to organize a conference like this, but I'm sure it's going to be very difficult also for the participants. However, we hope that you will be able to enjoy talks, people, discussions on topics which are not exactly in your particular field. This is the conference to really benefit from all of this. So I just want to thank you all for joining us in these efforts joining these conferences. You are the real objective of having us here. You are the real reason for the associations and the organizers of organizing these conferences. Joining all these efforts together will allow us to live during these few days the largest conference on computational mechanics ever. So thank you and enjoy.
I would like now to pass the word to Professor Ekehard Lam, President of ECCOMAS.
Dear authorities, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of ECCOMAS, the other association standing behind this conference, I would like to also welcome you to this conference. I'm sure that if I would ask everybody here in the audience, what does the acronym ECCOMAS stand for? Many of you could not give an exact answer. ECCOMAS is a European community on computational methods and applied sciences. It is a very young organization founded in 1993. It is the umbrella association. It is the umbrella association representing 24 national and regional associations in 33 European countries. Applied sciences, I stress this point, our predecessors have anticipated what really happened in the last field in our area, understanding also that engineering is an applied science. This is also reflected in the objective of ECCOMAS, as summarized here on this picture. You see, it refers to a broader field of numerical methods and computer simulations in engineering and applied sciences. Computational solid and structural mechanics, fluid dynamics being in the focus, but other fields are also very important, of course, applied mathematics and computer sciences, and others like physics. ECCOMAS has a very clear and successful conference structure. Congress every 4 years in between the conference on computational solids and structures and coupled problems, ECCM, and the conference on computational fluid dynamics, the ECFD, both joined here with the IACM, the international conference. And we have this very successful system of thematic conferences in odd years, not to forget the recently established Young Investigator Conference. Our meeting here is truly a mega event. It is big, always beautiful. What's the meaning of such a big conference? It is a distinct indication, in my opinion, maybe a demonstration of the development in our field in the last years. And in so far, it has also a political dimension. A mega event requires a mega organization. What I see here in Barcelona, this team have done a marvelous job, and I would like to thank all these people who are involved, the three chairmen and the teams, for this tremendous achievement they have done. The plane, Eugenio, is now flying. So you have to fly and on Friday touch down again. To finish up, I would like to make you aware of our next ECCOMAS Congress in 2 years, the Crete 2016 Congress organized by Professor Manolis Papadakakis. You are all cordially invited to attend this meeting on this wonderful Greek island in the Mediterranean, having a long historical tradition. I wish us all a wonderful and successful conference. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Ran. It is now the turn of Professor Yenki Yagawa, President of the IACM.
Dear colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to welcome you to the WCCM, ECCM, and ECFD Joint Congress. In this event, the 11th World Congress on Computational Mechanics of IACM, the 5th European Conference on Computational Mechanics of ECCOMAS, and the 6th European Conference on Computational Fluid Dynamics of ECCOMAS are joined. The success of this joint Congress is clearly shown by the large number of participants, over 3,600. This is really epoch-making in the history of the past Congresses of IACM and ECCOMAS. The success of this joint Congress is also reflected in the content of the technical program. Some 230 mini symposia and technical sessions have been organized by leading scientists and engineers in topics covering most disciplines in computational science and engineering, ranging from advances in fundamental and emerging areas of computational mechanics to innovative applications in technological fields. The Congress program therefore covers the state of the art on the theory and application of computational mechanics in many areas of engineering and applied sciences. I thank ECCOMAS, and in particular its President Professor Eckhard Ramm, for accepting to merge the WCCM with the ECCM and ECFD. I hope that this positive experience will be repeated in the future for the benefit of the community. computational community worldwide. Last but not least, I would like to thank the co-organizers of this joint congress, Professors Eugenio Oñate, Xavier Oliver, and Antonio Huerta, and the congress secretariat in Barcelona for an excellent and outstanding work. I hope that you enjoy attending the congress in the wonderful and beautiful city of Barcelona. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Yagawa. Finally, I would like to invite Professor Andreu Mas Miguel to close the opening addresses on behalf of the Catalonian government.
Thank you very much, members of the table, awardees, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to welcome all of you on behalf of the government of Catalonia, Barcelona being the capital of Catalonia. It gives me great satisfaction to meet among you for several reasons. One is that as an academic myself, I am an economist, and in economics we also have a relatively new discipline of computational economics that one could add to the list of applied science. And so it's very good to see the vitality of your disciplines in a very broad sense. And but maybe another reason, as a public servant, that I should be satisfied by you being here in such large numbers is because it shows that in this time of social networks and electronic communication, the wish, the urge of researchers to meet face to face has not decreased. This is, of course, good for those. For those cities, for those regions that take the business, the convention, conference, and visitors' business very seriously, which is our case. So I should tell you, desire you a very fruitful proceedings, do a lot of intellectual contact, but take some time also to enjoy the cities. I suppose that is that meaning the views, the shops, and the restaurants by the sea in the middle of by the hills. I should be careful not to point in any particular direction because those are different constituencies. But let me say that a good meal by any of those places is a wonderful way to brainstorm about your discipline, or more likely to gossip about your colleagues. finally, let me thank the local people that have made this possible, Professor Oñate, Professor Huerta, Professor Oliver. I know how difficult it is to carry through a project like this, and especially in times like this. So thank you thank you very much for pushing this activity and bringing this activity to Barcelona. Finally, I want to congratulate all the awardees and apologize for not being able to stay for the award ceremony. Thank you very much.
Many thanks, Professor Mastulelli. Computational Methods in Applied Sciences, ECCOMAS. The awards will be presented by Professor Ryan.
Thank you, Christina. Ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues and friends, as president of ECCOMAS, I have the great honor to introduce the ECCOMAS Award recipients for the year 2014. We have PhD awards, Young Investigator awards, and medals in this association. And you might most likely know that after a call for nominations, these awards are selected through secret voting by members of the award committees. On this occasion, I would like to thank all members of the committees very much for their commitment, as well as the Secretary of ECCOMAS, Professor Josef Eberhardsteiner, for guiding the process, and Itzhak Kotokar from the Barcelona Secretariat for his continued support. This time, we had a substantial number of nominations in all categories, high quality. Due to the tight schedule, I apologize that I cannot give any detailed laudations on every awardee. So let me start with the ECCOMAS PhD Awards for the best PhD thesis in 2013, that's the last year. You know, they finished their PhD in the last year. Every year, each of the 24 member association can propose one PhD dissertation. Inside each association, a rigorous selection took place beforehand. This year, we got 16 proposals for the association. So this is already the shortlist, so to speak. The ECCOMAS PhD Award Committee has selected two theses, one in the field of computational solids and structure, and the other one in the field of computational fluid dynamics. Let me first introduce both award winners and then I will hand out the certificates. The first PhD award in this area of computational solid structures goes to the civil engineer Dr. Francesc Verdugo, who made his PhD in applied mathematics at UPC here in Barcelona with a thesis on error estimates, assessment and adaptivity for structural transient dynamics. His PhD advisors are Professors Pedro Diaz and Dr. Nuria Paz. Dr. Verdugo works currently as postdoc at the Institute for Computational Mechanics at the Technical University of Munich. So, we come later to me, Gerard. The winner of the PhD Award 2013 in the field of computational fluid dynamics is Dr. Henning Sauerland, who made his PhD at the Chair for Computational Analysis of Technical System at Aachen University after graduating in computational engineering science. His thesis is entitled an XFEM-based sharp interface approach for two-phase and three-surface flows, supervised by Professors Marek Beer and Thomas Peter Fries. So congratulations to both of you for this special distinction. Please join us here and accept your certificate. The ECCOMAS Awards for Young Scientists, given every 2 years. These two awards are given to young investigators recognizing outstanding scientific accomplishments. The awards carry the names of two well-known scientists in our field, namely the Olivier Tsienkiewicz and Jacques-Louis Lyons, the engineer and the mathematician, representing two main fields of ECCOMAS. Let me first introduce them both and start with the Olivier Tsienkiewicz Award for Young Scientists in Computational Engineering Sciences. The award winner is Julien Yvonnet, professor at the University of Paris-Est in Marne-la-Vallée, France. Professor Yvonnet worked in multi-scale modeling of complex multi-physics heterogeneous materials and structures, nanomechanics, modeling of complex surfaces and interfaces, as well as forming processes. In recognition of his outstanding accomplishments, he was recently elected junior member of the prestigious University Institute of France. I translated that into English, maybe it's wrong, I don't know. So let me come to the second one, the Jacques Louis Lyons Award for Young Scientists in Computational Mathematics goes to Gianluigi Rozza, lecturer at the International School for Advanced Studies in Trieste, Italy. Dr. Rozza is well known for his outstanding contributions in the development of reduced order modeling techniques and computational reduction strategies for complex parameterized problems described by PDEs, and that in fluid as well as in solid mechanics. Dr. Rozza is a promising young scientist with a remarkable commitment in research and teaching. We, ECCOMAS, are very proud of these two brilliant young investigators, and please come to the podium here to me and receive the award certificates.
Was a landmark for reliable finite element analyses.
The spectrum of his research is not limited to fundamental theoretical results, but reaches into areas like bifurcation problems, plates and shells, finite elements, stabilization techniques, residual free bubbles, subgrid scale simulations, and recently virtual elements. The list is by far not complete. As a personal remark, I would like to say that I'm always excited when I listen to his enthusiastic and lively talk. Franco, I'm very much honored to present the ECCOMAS Leonard Euler Medal to you. So that concludes the ECCOMAS award ceremony. Thank you all very much, and once more again, congratulations to the ECCOMAS award winners. Thank you.
International Association for Computational Mechanics, IACM. The awards will be presented by Professors Yagawa and Werk. Please.
Well, hello everybody. You know, awards are given by IACM as a great honor, and it's not easy. We had two committees, the Major Award Committee and the General Award Committee, both chaired by Professor Eckhard Ramm. We have the name of the awards, the members of the committee who had to take the difficult decision to find the awardees on the webpage of IACM. I will be reading the awardees and the prizes, and Professor Yagawa, President of IACM, will be giving. First, the IACM Fellows. IACM Fellows are a selected group of members of our community, strictly chosen, and as you can see, Fellows are people recognized individuals with a distinguished record on research, accomplishment and publication in areas of computational mechanics, and demonstrated support to the IACM membership. I will read the names. You come and pick up your award, and while you take the pictures, I will write a few sentences. Okay? So, the first ECCM fellow this year is Professor Marek Baer. Congratulations. Marek Baer is Professor of Mechanical Engineering and holder of the Chair of Computational Analysis of the of Technical Systems at Aachen University. And he is the scientific director of the Aachen Institute for Advanced Studies in Computational Engineering Sciences. You probably know his recent work on quantification of biocompatibility of medical blood handling devices. Congratulations. Next fellow, John E. Dolbo. Congratulations. He is the York Family Professor of Civil and Environmental Engineering at Duke University. He also holds positions in mechanical, in the Department of Mechanical and Natural Science, and in the Department of Mathematics. He got his PhD from Northwestern University. His research activities, as you all know, primarily focus on numerical methods in evolving interface problems, and he's also one of the progenitors of the well-known extended finite element method. Congratulations. The next awardee is Professor Paolo Pimenta, professor of the Polytechnic School at the University of Sao Paulo. His main research is computational solid mechanics, with important contributions in rods and shells. And I must say, that he was consulting for the construction of the Brazilian National Stadium and the Maracanã Stadium. But you always have to remember that he got his PhD in Stuttgart. So everything makes sense. The following fellow is Professor Kumar Tama. He's currently professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering of the College of Science and Engineering at the University of Minnesota. He has published over 200 research papers and several books, and his research encompasses many fields. Congratulations. Next, Professor Pedro Tejada. He is professor of the Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering at the International Research Institute of Disaster Science in Tohoku University. Well, we know that that university was seriously hit during the Fukushima earthquake in April, and you probably know his work on heterogeneous material and the finite cover method. Congratulations. Thank you. Our last fellow of this year's awards is Professor Shinobu Yoshimura. He is professor of the Department of Civil and Environment, of the Department of Systems and Innovation of the University of Tokyo. And he is president of the Japan Association of Computational Mechanics. He has published over 220 papers, and you probably know him by the advanced parallel finite element analysis software known as Adventure. Congratulations. That was for the fellows. Now we move to the IACM John I. Jarry's Award for Young Scientists. This is an award for young scientists which recognize their exceptional accomplishments, particularly outstanding published paper. And let me thank and note that this award is sponsored by the Sevier. So I will ask Ms. Carrie Christensen, publishing editor, Elsevier publisher based in the New York office, to join us, because as this is the only IACM award which is actually sponsored. So thank you very much, Elsevier, for doing that. The prize this year goes to Alessandro Real. Alessandro is Associate Professor of Mechanics of Solids and Structures at the University of Pavia. You probably know his work on isogeometric analysis and the impact of all his publications. Congratulations. And just let me point out that this is not the only award he has received. He has received lots, but he is one of the holders of our ERC starting grant. Congratulations. The IACM Award. The IACM Award is given in recognition of outstanding and sustained contributions to the broad field of computational mechanics, and also special contributions in leadership and administration, industrial applications, in engineering analysis that advance computational mechanics. This year, the award goes for J.N. Reddy. Reddy is the inaugural holder of the Oscar S. Wyatt Endowed Chair at Texas A&M University, where he founded the Advanced Computational Mechanics Laboratory dedicated to state-of-the-art research in the development of novel mathematical models and numerical simulations in physics. There are lots of different projects carried out at that laboratory, including variational principles, theoretical mechanics, mathematical theory, and mixed and penalty methods, analytical solutions to refine theories, Newtonian and non-Newtonian problems, variational methods, and so on. His book, An Introduction to the Finite Element Method, was, for example, and had a large impact on two generations of engineers and students. Congratulations, Jay. The IACM Award on Computational Mechanics. This is an award given for contributions to traditional areas such as computational structure mechanics and CFD, but also to others with the general applicability of computational mechanics. This year, the award goes to Professor Lenzek Demkovic. Lenzek is Assistant Director of the Institute of Computational Engineering and Sciences and holder of the W. Tech Moncrief Junior Chair in Computational Engineering and Sciences at ICES. He is professor in the Department of Aerospace Engineering and Engineering Mechanics and in the Department of Mathematics of the University of Texas at Austin. His work spans across numerical analysis, higher order adaptive finite element methods, wave propagation problems, and CFD. And in the past years, in the past 5 years, his work focuses mainly on discontinuous petrocalorific methods. In fact, I should stop here, that was my original plan, but everybody knows the integrity of Lenzek, so he asked me to go on saying this method was co-invented with Jay Gopalakrishnan from Portland State University. Congratulations. And the final award from IACM, the IACM Congress Medal, the Gauss-Newton Medal. This is the highest award given by IACM, and it honors individuals who have made outstanding and sustained contributions in the field of computational mechanics, generally over periods representing substantial portions of their professional careers. You can see in the picture that the medal carries the images of Newton and Gauss in recognition of the synergy between mathematics, numerical analysis, and mathematical modeling of physics events that underpin much of the broad field of computational mechanics. This year, the award goes to Professor Chapelle Farhat. Congratulations. Chapelle Farhat is the Vivian Church Hof Professor of Aircraft Structures, Chairman of the Department of Aeronautics and Astronomics, Director of the Army Research for the Army High Performance Computing Research Center, and Director of the King Abdullah City of Science and Technology Center of Excellence for Aeronautics and Astronautics at Stanford University. His research interests are in computational engineering science for the design and analysis of complex systems in aerospace, mechanical, and naval engineering. He's member of the National Academy and fellow of a large number of societies, among which IACM, of course, ASME, IAAA, and so on. He was knighted of the Order of the Academic Palms and awarded La Médaille de Chevalier de l'Ordre des Palmes Académiques. He was also nominated by the US Navy Recruiters of San Francisco as primary key influencer to be flown by the Blue Angels during the flight week 2014. I hope we will still have you after that flying experience. He is recipient of many professional and academic distinctions during the Lifetime Achievement Awards, award from ASME, the Structures and Structural Dynamics Materials Award from IAAA, the John von Neumann Medal from the USACM, the IACM Award on Computational Mechanics, the IACM Award, the Gordon Penn Prize and CIMNE Fenchbach Award from the Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, and the Modeling and Simulation Award from the US Department of Defense. Congratulations, Chapelle. As there is also this tradition for a long time, the Gauss-Newton medalist will say a few words.
Good morning, everyone. It is a great honor for me to stand here today. I'm sincerely grateful for my nomination and selection for the Gauss-Newton Medal, and I'm pleased to accept it. I want to thank all those who made this possible. First, my academic mentors of 28 years ago. There is not a single day of my professional life where I'm not reminded of one or another aspect of my intellectual growth at UC Berkeley. When in doubt, I find myself going back to the same sources. What I learned from Jerry Stackman, Ray Clough, Jim Kelly, Bob Taylor, Beresford Parlett, and of course, Ed Wilson. It is also at Berkeley that I was fortunate to meet Bob Milosh during his sabbatical visit. He taught me another dimension of the finite element method. It is also there where I attended my first seminar in computational mechanics, and guess by who? No one else than Peter Riggers. It is also at Berkeley where I had the privilege to meet the superstar of computational mechanics. He had a great sense of humor. I asked him one day why I must compute a certain elastoplastic quantity the way he insisted I should. Because everybody in the world does it this way, he replied. I was not convinced, so I asked him again, who is everybody? He responded, Bob Taylor, John Holquist, and everyone at LBL. Ladies and gentlemen, this was the great Spaniard, Juan Simón. This exchange was a stark testimony to the role of the Bay Area in the field of computational mechanics, and this is my homage to the great contributions of Spain to this field. I also want to pay a special tribute to Casey Park and Carlos Felipa, who mentored me early in my career at the University of Colorado. They also introduced me to two other people who influenced my scientific life. First, Michel Gérardin from the University of Liège. His passion for working with the industry and for creative problem solving rubbed off on me very quickly. Second, Roger Oyon, who introduced me to the world of fluid structure interaction 26 years ago by sloshing his wine at the Hilton Waikiki Hotel in Hawaii. Last but not least, I want to express my deep gratitude to all my students. They are the only giants on whose shoulders I have stood so that I can stand in front of you today. So far, computational mechanics has been a very rewarding profession for me. From the great days of rich computations on the IBM punch cards in the basement of Berkeley's Evans Hall, to last week's simulation of the maneuvering of a sleek vehicle on one of the largest supercomputers in the world. It has not only provided me the intellectual challenges needed to stimulate my academic life, but also the opportunity to ride a submarine, a Formula One car, and hopefully fulfill my dreams by flying next October with the Blue Angels. I have lost 18 pounds for this purpose. Not because of the weight maximum limit of the F/A-18 Super Hornet, but because of that of his ejection seat, which hopefully I will not need. The next generation of computational mechanics is in your hands, you, the younger generation of this audience. You can make it as exciting as you want. For this, you really don't need my advice. As a matter of fact, you don't need anyone else's advice. But I cannot resist the urge to tell you that among the most exciting things you can do is to transform computational mechanics so that it can stir the imagination and dialogue on how more radical technologies and concepts can help our society. Your era should not be that of the citation index. It should be that of transforming computational mechanics into an enabler of personal spaceflight, space tourism, carbon nanotubes, photonic laser thrusters, alternative fuel, flying cars, cellular therapeutics, and mobile apps. Originality and impact on the real world are more vital today than have ever been. To conclude, I thank IACM and its founders. I was never the child prodigy that Gauss was. And unlike Newton, I did not develop any new vision last time anything fell on my head. But I'm honored to receive this award which bears their names. I'm a proud member of this association, and I will continue to serve it. Thank you.
congratulations to all the IACM colleagues. Ladies and gentlemen, our Latin session is now concluded. However, before we start with the technical part of the meeting, I invite you to stay alert for a moment. Let's discover together what is coming on now.
Thank you.
Mr. Kim Moya. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.